Alright, so like I said, we want to draw major scale on this staff now for Kisi. So this is what major scale for Kisi would look like. And we have the staff here, we have the staff here. This is C, then next we have a D in between this first line and the ledger line, the first ledger line. Then we have F, I mean E here followed by F, G, A. This is what it will look like for a major scale. Now, the other time I said we could have minor scale now. I want to write for minor scale. In key C, I'm saying key C. So I have root note, which is number one. This is the formula for minor. O step, half step, O step, O step, half step, O step, O step. So now I have C, and I have the O step to D, so I have D. I have half step now, so I have E flat now. I have O step, so I have F. I have another O step, I have G. I have half step now, then I should be having A flat. And I have O step from A flat, which is this. So I have a B flat, sorry, not A sharp, B flat. Then I have another O step from B flat now. You will see. So this is exactly what it will look. Let me clean up this formula now. This is what C minor would look like. So it should be 7 if I'm correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this is number 1 again. So now we have C. This is C. We have D. This is D. We have E flat. So I'll just turn this to E flat. Since we already know that E and E flat will fall on this line. It's only to denote them with the sign. So our F, this is F. We have G there, this is G. We have A flat now. This is A flat. We have B flat, and this is B flat. Then we have C. So this is typically what minor scale will look like for KC. Okay? So now I'll be talking next on relative minor and relative major. How you can derive a minor note from a major note. That is what I'll be doing next time. Like I said, I want to do relative minor of key C now. Now, there's a way to get a minor note from this, a minor scale from this major scale. Now, what you will do is just come to the third, you flat this C by 3 steps. Now, come from C now. We have number one flat is B. You flat it by B. You flat it by this space. And you flat it. You come to this A. You move from this C. Come to B. Come to this space, which is B flat. And you come to this, which is A. So if you do that, you will be getting a relative minor for key C, which will be A now. Now, let me quickly draw chromatic of A. Then we'll derive minor scale from A. What you will discover is we have the same note that we have for major of A. Now, number one will be A. Then we have our A sharp. Or let me say B flat. It's still the same thing. Now we have our B, we have our C, we have our D flat, then we have D, then we have our E flat, then we have E, then we have F. Then we can have F. Okay, we can have our G flat instead of F, since I'm writing for order of flat. Then we can have our G, then we can have our A flat, then we have A now, which is the 12th note. Now, I said for minor scale of A. Now, we have a formula that says O step, half step, O step, O step, half step, O step, O step. Now. Now let's form this now. We have A number one note. Then we have an O step. Then we go to B. We have half step. Okay. Yes, we have half step next. A is our root note. Then we take O step. We come to B. Then we take half step. We go to C now. Then we take O step again, which is this. We have our from C we take O step. We come to D. From D now we take O step again, we come to E. Now from E we take half step, so we come from E to F. From F now we take O step, so we come to G. And from G, we come, we take O step and we go to E. So if you could see now, this is what a minor scale in key of A looks like. And if you now compare it with this major scale of C, this is major for C. Major scale of C. Now, if you compare the two, you will see this, they have the same notes in between them. We have C here, we have C, we have D here, D, E, E, and likewise, and the rest. Now, what you will discover is that if you are on C here, on key C major scale, and you come 3 steps downward, you will get to A. Now, if you now draw from this one now, you come to A here, you get A here, you will see a C, I mean a B, sorry. You have B here, a C here, you have C here. Then come back here, you will see D. You see E here, you see F here, you see. So what this is telling you is that if you have a major scale, just come back 3 steps, then you will get to its relative minor. In this case, we are in key of C. So if you come back 3 steps, now from B to B flat to A, you get the relative minor. This is applicable also to any key that we have. If you flat it 3 steps, if you come back 3 steps, you have a relative minor. And likewise in minor too. If you come from A now, you come to A sharp, you come to B, and you come to C, then you have a relative major in minor. This is very important to know so that when we start playing now and we start building blocks, we are all doing this major minor thing so that it will be much easier when we are building our blocks on the guitar. So this is what relative major, relative minor is. I will advise you, try this on other keys. You can try it on F, F sharp, E, any key. You will get this. So far, you follow the formulas. Now, we talked about chromatic scale, we talked about major scale, we talked about minor scale, and we talked about relative major from minor and relative minor from major. So that is the end of the class today. And that this is all we'll be talking about. So please, let's try this. Let's make sure we practice this, write them down, and try them for other keys. Thank you so much.